do you mean?
Like, see over there? Is that turning on now? See that?
Oh, yeah, I see that.
Look there, it's a big circle.
Oh, the little campfire up there.
Look at this side, see the ton of little ones.
Little lips?
Hey, you should name them.
Name them?
Yeah, sure, name us. What do you think of it? I'm a part of the constellation of Pegasus, the winged horse.
Well, since you mentioned it, I am known as Sierra.
Sorry, I mentioned it. You know, Percy, it looked more, I don't know, trying to talk. What are you doing?
Yeah, it's definitely my name. I'm tired of being mistaken for a plant.
I don't need to spend my time stargazing.
Good advice. I should put that on my space balloon.
Wait, you have a space balloon? Wait, you have a boat?
Sure do. Ascension is great up here. So close to the satellites.
Hi, Jen. Hi, Cassie.
Ah, Earth. One of the most beautiful places in the whole universe.
Is it just me, or does it feel like something big is about to happen down there?
I feel it, too.
I'm sure there's something happening right here.
In my electrons.
An extra little shimmer?
Or twinkling, maybe?
Wow, that was fast! What is it?
Oh, probably just another mineral.
Oh, look, the night's almost over.
The little lights are going on.
Yup, here comes the sun.
Thank you.
Jack. Hi, Carl. Have you seen this?
What is it?
It's sort of a calendar. So what does it say?
It looks like the time has come for us to get up to this planet.
What plan?
His plan for eternity is to send his one and only son to Earth to be a savior.
To Earth? Why Earth? It's just a little speck in the cosmos.
Carl, you always say that.
Well, it's true. What makes Earth so special? Just because it has a moment?
Yes.
Yes. One word. Love.
God made the humans in his image, and he loves them so much, he's ready to send his only son there.
And believe me, they need him. Boy, did they need him. Okay, yeah, I've heard about that.
But what does that have to do with us?
Job for a big star,
the brightest star.
Can you imagine the King of Kings going to Earth?
No wonder one of us will be asked to shine.
It will be so magnificent. He will be called Wonderful Counselor.
Mighty God, Everlasting Father,
the Prince of Peace.
Doesn't that call for an entire constellation? It says here, just one star.
Really? Just one?
There must be one really bright, incredible star there.
Finding the right star for the job, that could take light years.
Well, God did create all the stars, and he calls each of us by name. There are so many. How will he decide?
I don't know about all of you, but I'm going to shine as brightly as possible.
Yeah, me too. Oh.
Would you look at Bob? He's just the sweetest little star.
Maybe a little dim compared to the rest of us.
He's always doing nice things like
picking up after stars like you.
Do you think maybe...
Think what?
That Bob might, I don't know, have the right idea, you know, about how to be the best star?
Now. It sounds like it's so much special. Someone who can get the job done. It looks like it's someone important. And who knows, maybe I am the one. You think this could be your
Well, he's not looking out like the rest of us, I can tell you that.
But all for a good cause, right?
Right, who wouldn't want to be the star of Bethlehem?
No kidding, that'll definitely get you on the star charts.
Would it? Isn't this just a one-time gig?
Yeah, but it's still worth it.
Shine on!
Reach for the stars.
Look, there...
Yes.
sent to Earth as a tiny baby?
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill Thank you. Okay, make sure I don't forget this later, okay? Our passage today comes from the prophet Isaiah.
今天我们要传讲的经文是以赛亚书。
And I'd like to give you a very brief background.
首先要给大家以赛亚书一些背景的信息。
Isaiah's prophetic ministry spanned a huge period of time.
以赛亚先知的事工跨越了很长的一段时间。
Those were times of turmoil for the nation of Israel.
这段时间正是以色列动荡不安的时期。
From the looming Assyrian invasion of the northern kingdom.
当时亚述大军压境，来要侵略北国以色列。
To the Babylonian captivity of Judah and then ultimately Jerusalem.
接着又有巴比伦来侵略，掳掠了南国犹大，甚至耶路撒冷。
The majority of the book of Isaiah, besides a couple of bright spots,
在以赛亚书里面，除了一点点是振奋人心的消息以外，
most of Isaiah is doom and gloom.
大部分的信息都是非常的压抑，非常的黑暗。
It's darkness and impending wrath.
非常的黑暗，而且有神即将来临的愤怒。
Yes, we get a couple of servant songs.
是的，当中有几章是讲到仆人之歌。A
few messianic prophecies.
有几章是讲到弥赛亚的预言。Which
we love bringing out during the holidays.
我们在圣诞期间常常会提到这些。And
near the end, there are a few chapters of restoration and new creation.
在以赛亚书最后也讲到了恢复和新的创造。
But for the most part, we must not forget that Isaiah is a book of judgment.
但是我们不要忘了，以赛亚书大部分的内容讲的都是神的审判。
Israel has faced multiple existential crises throughout her history.
在当时以色列国经历了多重的生死存亡的
So it was understandable if the people, they would ask this most basic question.
所以当人们问了这样一个很基本的问题的时候，我们也能够理解。
Because we have forgotten the Lord, has the Lord forgotten us?
是不是因为我们忘记了神，所以神也忘记了我们呢？
Has God abandoned us?
上帝是不是抛弃了我们呢？
Is that why we are now experiencing such tragedies?
是不是因为这样，所以我们在经历这样的苦难呢？
So, with that bleak background in mind, let's begin looking at our passage, shall we?
让我们看今天的经文。
Isaiah chapter 49, verse 13 and 14. Sing for joy, O heavens, and exult, O earth, break forth, O mountains, into singing, for the Lord has comforted his people and will have compassion on his afflicted. But Zion said, The Lord has forsaken me, my Lord has forgotten me.
今天的经文是以赛亚书49章13到16节，现在读13到14节。 诸天哪，应当欢呼，大地啊，应当快乐，众山哪，应当发声歌唱，因为耶和华已经安慰他的百姓，也要怜恤他困苦之民。锡安说：“耶和华离弃了我，主忘记了我。”
Why did Zion, Jerusalem, the city of God, why did they feel like they had been forsaken, forgotten by the Lord?
为什么锡安？ 耶路撒冷神的圣城的人民，他们觉得被神忘记了呢？
Because they knew all too well their own failures.
因为他们深深地知道他们得罪了神。
Their sins and their shortcomings.
他们亏欠了神，他们的罪。
In fact, Isaiah has spent the last 40 chapters reminding them.
事实上，以赛亚书有四十章的经文，不断地提醒以色列人。
And warning them of the judgment to come.
提醒他们神的愤怒，神的审判即将来临。
And they knew it to be true.
他们也知道这是真的。
It is true. Nobody knows our sins like we do.
确实如此，没有人能够清楚知道我们自己的罪，就像我
，nobody,
除了我们自己。
Nobody except God, that is.
除了神以外，只有我们自己最清楚我们自己的罪。
We are our own worst critic.
我们常常是对自己最大批判的人。
Isn't it true, brothers and sisters, that we will forget when people praise us, appreciate us, thank us?
弟兄姐妹们，我们是不是常常忘记别人赞美我们、欣赏我们或者感谢我们的时候呢？
But we will remember the criticisms, the disagreements, the times when others point out our failures.
但是我们会记得别人对我的批评，我们和别人的分歧，或者别人指出我们不足的地方的这些时候。
Yes, they are hard to swallow.
是的，这些都很难接受。
And so difficult to forgive and forget.
也很难原谅和忘记。
Yes, we are hard on ourselves.
是的，我们对自己都很苛刻。
As was Israel, rightly so.
以色列人也是如此，而他们也有理由这样做。
They knew all too well that they had failed in their covenant keeping.
他们非常的清楚，他们没有遵守神的诫命和典章。
They felt it too.
他们失败了。
Verse 14, look at it again.
在十四节，我们再看一次。
But Zion said, "The Lord has forsaken me; my Lord has forgotten me."
十四节，锡安说：“耶和华离弃了我，主忘记了我。”
Can you hear their desperation, their hopelessness?
你们可以听到他们的无助和绝望吗？
Israel had a clear sense of her sin.
以色列人对他们所犯的罪非常的清楚。
And the wages of those sins.
他对他罪的工价也非常的理解。
Well, how will the Lord respond to this?
那上帝是如何回应他们的提问呢？
Will God agree?
上帝同意他们的问题吗？
Will he?Respond with further condemnation.
是不是上帝更加的谴责他们呢？
No, on the contrary, with love, tenderness, and care.
不是的，完全相反，上帝的回应是有爱和温柔和关切来回应。
Verse 15 and 16. Can a woman forget her nursing child?That she should have no compassion on the son of her womb. Even these may forget, yet I will not forget you. Behold, I have engraved you on the palms of my hands. Your walls are continually before me.
在接下来十五、十六节是神的回答：妇人岂能忘记她吃奶的婴孩，不怜恤她所生的儿子？即或有忘记的，我却不忘记你。看哪，我将你。铭刻在我掌上，你的强环常在我眼前。
Beautiful imagery.
很美的一个图画。
Imagine a newborn baby secure in his mother's arms.
想象一下一个新生的婴孩在他的母亲的怀里得到安详。
Can you imagine it?
你能够想象吗？
Because that is the picture Isaiah has given us.
这个图画就是以赛亚书所描绘的。
Of the lavish love of God.
就神对我们长阔高深的爱。
Keep that picture of the baby in mother's arms in your mind.
让我们在脑子里保留这个图画。
Don't forget it.
不要忘记。
At Christmas time, we celebrate rightly. The birth of baby Jesus.
在圣诞佳节的时候，我们 是庆祝耶稣 baby 耶稣的诞生。
The incarnate Son of God.
是神道成肉身的儿子。
But we tend to forget that God had another son.
但是我们常常忘记上帝还有一个儿子。
Centuries before Christ was born.
就在耶稣诞生前很多年的时候就有了。
Not by flesh.
不是肉体而生的。
But by election.
而是靠着拣选。
Sovereign choice.
靠着神的拣选，主权的拣选。
God had another son.
上帝还有一个儿子。
Israel was God's firstborn son.
以色列是神的长子。
In Exodus chapter 4, Yahweh speaks to Moses from the burning bush.
在出埃及记第四章，耶和华在荆棘火焰中对摩西说话。
And God reveals himself, his personal name.
耶和华对摩西显现了他的名字。
And he gives Moses his mission.
也给赋予了摩西他的使命。
Exodus chapter 4, verse 22 and 23 says, this is God speaking.Then you shall say to Pharaoh, Thus says the Lord, Israel is my firstborn son. And I say to you, Let my son go, that he may serve me. If you refuse to let him go, behold, I will kill your firstborn son.
出埃及记第四章二十二到二十三节，你要对法老说，耶和华这样说，以色列是我的长子，我的。是我的儿子，我的长子。我对你说过，容我的儿子去，好侍奉我。你还是不肯容他去。看哪，我要杀你的长子。
The death of a royal son for the freedom of many slaves.
用一个皇室的儿子的死，来换取许多奴隶的儿女们的自由。
Isn't that an echo of the gospel?
这不正是福音的反射吗？
But how could God justify this?
但是上帝怎么能够为他的行为辩护呢？
The killing of an innocent child.
杀害一个无辜的孩子。
What is his motivation?
他的动机是什么？
It is his great love.
这正是他的大爱。
You see, God himself was willing to pay that ultimate price.
上帝他本身愿意付出这最终的代价。
Because he loves his children that much.
因为他如此的爱他的儿女们。
And he did pay that price.
而他确实付上了这个代价。
2,000 Christmases ago.
在两千多年前的圣诞节。
2,000 Christmases ago.
两千个圣诞节之前。
John 3:16 and 17. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him.
约翰福音三章十六节到十七节。神爱世人，甚至将他的独生子赐给他们，叫一切信他的不至灭亡，反得永生。因为神差他的儿子降世，不是要定世人的罪，乃是要叫世人因他得救。
You see, God is not some angry tyrant seeking to get revenge on rebellious citizens.
你们看到了吗？上帝他不是一个愤怒的暴君，寻找机会来报复他的子民。
Do you see that he is a loving father, willing to send and sacrifice his son to rescue his adoptive sons and daughters?
你看到他是一个慈爱的父亲，他愿意牺牲他自己亲生儿子的性命，来拯救他所收养的儿女们的性命。
And God did this to set right what is wrong.In this fallen, sin-filled, sinful world.
上帝这样做是为了将这个充满了罪恶、充满堕落的世界纠正过来。
And that is good news of great joy for all the people.
而这对我们就是我们要听到的好消息和大喜乐。
Okay, back to today's passage, back to Isaiah.
我们再回到以赛亚书。
God is pictured as a loving mother caring for her baby.
上帝被描绘成为一个充满了慈爱的母亲来照顾她的婴孩。
Verse 15 and 16. Can a woman forget her nursing child that she should have no compassion on the son of her womb? Even these may forget, yet I will not forget you. Behold, I have engraved you on the palms of my hands. Your walls are continually before me.
十五节，妇人岂能忘记她吃奶的婴孩，不怜恤她所生的儿子？即或有忘记的，我却不忘记你。看哪，我帮你，我将你刻铭刻在我掌上，你的强援常在我眼前。
God says essentially, even if a mother could forget her own baby, I will never forget you.
上帝说，即使一个母亲也有或有可能忘记自己的婴孩，我也永远不会忘记你。
We know that human love is imperfect.
我们知道人与人之间的爱是不完全的。
Because there are indeed mothers who forget their children.
因为现实上确实有母亲抛弃了她的孩子。
To abortion or abandonment.
可能是堕胎，也可能是遗弃。
As unthinkable and shocking as that may seem,
这些听起来都很让人吃惊，也可能听着很难想象。
The truth is, it happens.
但事实上，这些确实发生。
It happens.
确实发生。
So when Isaiah asks the rhetorical question, "Can a woman forget her nursing child?"
所以当以赛亚问这个反问句的时候，难道一个母亲会忘记她的孩子吗？
We're led to confess that, sadly, yes.
我们不由自主地来承认。
It happens.
是的，有可能。
It happens. Which makes the Lord's response so reassuring.
正因为如此，当上帝的回答是这样的时候，我们听见就特别的被安慰。
In the end of verse 15, he says, "Even these may forget, yet I will not forget you."
因为上帝说，即使他们有可能忘记，我也绝对不会忘记你。
God is speaking to His firstborn son.
上帝在这里是对他的头生子以色列所说的。
Israel, and also by extension and incorporation, all of us.
但同时也是对所有在基督里成为他的儿女的信徒说的。
His sons and daughters in Christ.
因为我们也是因信称义，同蒙应许。
God's love is perfect, persevering, and pricey.
上帝的爱是完美的，是持久的，也是付上代价的。
2 months ago, my sister gave birth to my nephew, Shiloh.
两个月前，我的妹妹生了个孩子，我的外甥。
And she made me an uncle.
我就成了舅舅。
When I talk to her now, I am reminded of the enormous sacrifices a mother makes for her baby.
当我和她聊天的时候，让我想起了一位母亲要为孩子所做出的巨大的牺牲。
The pumping, the midnight feedings, the burping, the swaddling, all those diaper changes.
作为母亲，她必须要半夜喂奶，要帮 baby 打嗝，要去摇他睡觉，换尿布等等，还要不断的去查看他的情况。
The diapers, the endless diapers, and the constant baby monitoring.
要不停的换尿布，还要不停的去查看 baby。
Yeah, all that fun stuff we parents tend to forget all about.
我们做父母的已经忘记这些有趣的事情。
At least I've forgotten all about it.
我已经忘记了。
Yes, there is a costliness to love.
是的，爱是要付出代价的。
Love is seen through sacrifice.
爱也是用牺牲的方式来表达。
And God's love is no different.
神对我们的爱也是如此。
Look, God says, "Your walls are continually before me."
上帝说，你的墙垣常在我眼前。
It means I'm always watching you.
意思说，我一直在看着你，照顾着你。
Monitoring you.
呀，观看，关注着你。
And look again, I have engraved you on the palms of my hands.
我们再看这句，我将你铭刻在我的掌上。
Now, the original meaning of this probably refers to a tattoo.
这句话可能原来的意思是指刺青。
It would have been a constant reminder, right?
这是作为一个常常提醒的记号。
Anytime God does anything,
任何时候神做什么事情的时候，
whenever God opens his hands to do something,
不管当神打开他手的时候来做事情，
Our names are there.
我们的名字在那里。
And he remembers us.
他记得我们。
I have engraved you on the palms of my hands.
我将你铭刻在我掌上。
Well, this line takes on so much more meaning 33 years after that first Christmas, doesn't it?
这句话在耶稣诞生了33年以后又赋予了新的意义。
Engraved on the palms of his hands by the cross.
铭刻在掌上，耶稣用十字架将我们的名字铭刻在他掌上。
For your sins and mine.
为了你和我的罪。
He did that for you and for me.
他为了你和我。
So we could becomeSons and daughters of God.
正因为如此，我们才能成为他的儿女。
Jesus invites us to be his siblings.
耶稣邀请我们做他的兄弟姐妹。
Brothers and sisters, you are unforgettable for eternity.
弟兄姐妹们，你在神永恒的国度里是不会被忘记的。
So,Go to God, secure in His love.
所以去到来到神的面前，来安享他所提供给我们的安稳。
Okay, brothers and sisters, here's my main point and my encouragement for Christmas.
所以今天我主要跟大家分享的主要要点就是
Never forget that you are not forgotten.
永远不要忘记。你没有被遗忘。
And even the darkest days, the longest nights, He is continually watching over you.
即使在最黑暗的日子，在最漫长的夜晚，他一直在看顾你。
He has engraved you on the palms of His hands.
他将你铭刻在他的掌上。
Because Jesus was sent,Jesus was born, Jesus died, and Jesus was raised.
因为耶稣他被差遣，他降生，他受死，他复活。
Your sins may be forgiven, but you are not forgotten.
我们的罪会被饶恕，但是我们是不会被忘记。
Let me say that again. Your sins may be forgiven,But you are not forgotten.
我们再重复一遍，你的罪会被赦免，而你不会被忘记。
Isn't that good news?
难道这不就是佳音吗？
That is good news. Well, what then shall we believe?
那我们应该相信什么呢？
And think about all this.
我们应该怎么去思考这一切呢？
Jesus, Jesus was born to fulfill what Israel, the firstborn son, failed to do.
耶稣他降生就是来完成以色列这个长子所不能完成的事情。
Yes, Israel did indeed fail to keep the old covenant.
是的，以色列他没有遵守盟约。
Which is why it is such good news that Jesus fulfilled it and gives us a new covenant in his blood.
所以好信息就是当耶稣来到世间，他给我们，他完成了需要做的，然后用他的血给我们立了新约。
Amen. Now, how is this meant to make us feel?
那你感觉如何？
Loved and cared for.
被爱和被照顾。
Like a baby resting in its mother's arms.
就像婴孩能够在他母亲的怀里安睡。
So we can rest in the loving care of our God.
我们也能在上帝的怀中安稳。
Remember, he is constantly watching over us.
别忘了，他一直在看着我们。
Protecting us.
保护我们。
Giving us everything we need to grow and mature in Christ.
供应我们日用的所需，让我们在主里面成长。
Isn't that a great comfort?
这是不是让我们很得安慰呢？
Okay, lastly, what then shall we do?
那我们要去做什么呢？
As the hands and feet of Christ, let us go and reach out to the forgotten.
我们作为主耶稣的手和脚，让我们出去，向那些被遗忘者伸出我们的援手。
Those who feel the weight of their sin, their unworthiness, they feel unloved by others, by God.
对那些他们感觉到自己罪孽深重，感觉到自己不配得到上帝的爱，也不配得到别人的爱。
I think we have a responsibility to love and accept others the way we have been loved and accepted by our Heavenly Father.
我觉得我们有责任去接纳和爱那些不被爱的人，就像我们的天父接纳和爱我们一样。
Unconditionally, non-judgmentally, forgivingly, graciously, and generously.
我们对他们的接纳和爱需要是无条件的，不加上论断的。
Let us love others.
亲切和慷慨的。
Let us love others as we have been loved.
让我们将神爱我们的爱来爱别人。
So, is there a foreign student who doesn't have local family or friends here?
那我们看看我们的周围有没有外国学生，他没有家人或亲友在这里。
Is there a coworker who nobody wants to hang out with?
或者有一位同事，没有人愿意和他一起出去吃饭。
A widow or widower with no relatives in town.
寡妇或者宽夫，他们没有亲人在身边。
Or even a homeless man living in his van, parked right outside.
或者一个无家可归的人，他就住在他的那个面包车里面，停在你的家门口。
面包车。What is, okay. Well,Then invite them in. Invite them in. Let them know that they are not forgotten.
那我们要邀请他们进来，让他们知道我们没有忘记他们。
They are not forgotten.
他们没有被遗忘。
By you or by Christ.
没有被你，也没有被神遗忘。
Remember, Christ came to save, seek and save the lost.
记得耶稣是来寻找和拯救失丧的人。
The outcast.
那些被边缘化的人。
The forgotten ones.
Yeah, 被遗忘的人。
So, brothers and sisters, because we are not forgotten, let us never forget others in their loneliness and their suffering.
弟兄姐妹们，因为我们没有被神遗忘，让我们也不要忘记那些住在孤独和痛苦中的人。
Merry Christmas.
圣诞快乐。
Christ has come.
耶稣在我们当中。
God is with us.
上帝与我们同在。
Hallelujah. Let's pray.
我们祷告。
Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for your love.
我们的天父，我们感谢你给我们的大爱。
That we are constantly on your mind.
我们不断地被提醒。
And that you would send your son to rescue us.
你派遣你的儿子来拯救我们。
Thank you, Lord, for sending your son.
感谢你派遣你的儿子。
So that we could be your sons and daughters.
所以我们能成为你的儿女。
Thank you.
感谢你。
We pray this in Jesus' name.
奉主耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
That's right. 站起来，我们一同来唱三一颂。
me try something. See if I still remember. 愿耶和华赐福给你，保护你。愿耶和华使他的脸光照你，赐恩给你。愿耶和华向你扬脸，赐你平安。The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. All of God's people said, Amen. Amen. Merry Christmas.
请坐。Please be seated. This is such a happy day. This is such a glory day that we need to give all the glory to our Lord. 今天是一个非常好的荣耀的日子，因为今天是庆祝耶稣基督的诞生。We would like to welcome someone who's new here, and we would like to express our appreciation and our welcome to you. 我们现在要欢迎一些新来的朋友，如果你是今天第一次来的，我们愿意欢迎你。May I ask, for those you are the first time coming here, would you please stand up? 如果是你第一次来我们教会，可以请你站起来吗？我们想欢迎你。Yes. Welcome. Please be seated. Yeah, well.We have some daily commerce on the upstairs over there. 我们有些在楼下，所以我们都欢迎你。We welcome all of you. You're the first time here joining us for this wonderful service. Jesus is the focus in this wonderful time of the year. 耶稣是最重要的，他是这个时间的主角。我们有些报告。We have some announcement. And first of all, just like Pastor Jim just mentioned, we wish you everybody a Merry Christmas. 祝大家圣诞快乐。那我们还有一件很重要的事情，就是今天我们有一个特别的有个 cookie 的那个交换那如果你有带 cookie 来的，那你就可以到那个交易厅，可以，如果你带十个来，你可以拿走十个；如果你带五个来，你可以拿走五个。那希望你们的数学都很好。Okay, we have a cookie swap right after, and if you bring five here, and you get five. If you get ten here, you get ten back home, right?So I hope you can count. All right, so if you, oh, by the way, if you don't have any cookie, what shall you do? Go and buy it before you go home. How's that? All right, 如果你没有带 cookie 来的话呢，你可以买一些回去，一家人可以分享一下。Again, today's Christmas time, Christmas Day,I wish everybody Merry Christmas. 祝大家圣诞快乐。我们一起可以默祷，默祷以后可以散会。Let's have a silent prayer, and then we can dismiss.